Hello, good morning friends. Today we will discuss regarding three-hinged arches. They are determinate structures. So arch is one of the oldest structure. Romans developed a semicircular true masonry arch which they used extensively in bridges and aqueducts. Quite a few of earlier Indian railways and highways use masonry arches. They were constructed with brick or stone with lime or cement mortar as the building material. Arches are also used in buildings to carry the loads over doorways, windows, etc., and as well as to add an aesthetic touch to the buildings. Theoretical arch or line of thrust. Arch structures behave in a similar way as cable structures, but with the actions reversed. In case of cable structures, the cable carries the loads in the form of tensile nature, whereas in case of arch, the arch carries the load in terms of compressive nature. Types of arches. Based on materials, that arches are classified as concrete and steel. Then based on structural behavior, the arches are defined as 2-hinged arch, 3-hinged arch, then fixed arch. Based on the form, it is classified as circular arch, parabolic arch and elliptical arch. So in our study here, we are going to study 3-hinged arches and that too parabolic arches. Types of arches. First one, you can see 3-hinged arch, B 2-hinged arch, C fixed arch, D tied arch, E 2-hinged arch with the crescent shape, then last one is 2-hinged spandrel braced arch. So you can see first 3-hinged arch is a statically determinate and others are all indeterminate structures. So comparison of bending moment diagram for a simple beam with a arch is illustrated here. If you consider a simple beam, simply supported beam with one end hinged and other end on rollers with a point load which is not at the center, the below diagram is the bending moment diagram. Whereas in case of arch structure, if the load, same load is applied at the same distance, then the bending moment is drastically reduced due to the moment induced by the horizontal thrust at A and B. So that is the advantage of arch compared to the beam. If you consider a simply supported beam with a point load at the center, the bending moment will be maximum at the center, and based on the bending moment, depth of the beam required for this bending moment will be very high for large spans. But if you consider same beam with the horizontal thrust and if it is bent into a shape of a arch, then the thickness is drastically reduced and also bending moment due to the horizontal thrust will be negative. So net of bending moment diagram for the arch will be very less. Hence, compared to simply supported beam, the thickness of the beam will be drastically reduced. So in case of 3-hinged arch, we can have three equations, that is sum of all the vertical forces equal to 0, sum of all the horizontal forces equal to 0, sum of moments equal to 0. A and B supports are called springings and C is called center crown. All three are hinged. In case of 3-hinged arches, there are four unknowns, that is a reaction at A, horizontal and vertical, reaction at B, horizontal and vertical. So three statical equilibriums are equations, and one more equation is formulated by using the condition that the moment at the crown hinge is zero. Thus the four equations are sufficient to determine the reactions at each support. The bending at the hinge at the crown provide an additional equation of equilibrium. The main advantage is that this is insensitive to foundation settlements and change of temperature. They are preferable for wide span roofs. This is less preferred in case of railway bridges because of the discontinuity at the crown hinge. So in case of 2-inch arch, if you see, there will be four unknowns, two horizontal and vertical reactions at each support. So there will be totally four unknowns. So in case of other types of arch also, there will be number of unknowns will be more, hence statically indeterminate. Comparison between 3-inch arch, 2-inch arch and fixed arches with respect to shape, if the in each type of arch, if they are proportioned with respect to its funicular shape, then no bending stresses develop. Thus, the funicular shape makes primarily the internal forces compressive or radial thrust. So, in case of support settlements, 3-inch arch is flexible. Each arch segment connecting the support hinge to be crown hinge rotates freely with respect to each other. In other words, provision of hinge makes it more flexible. In case of 2-inch arches, the vertical displacement makes the entire arch to deform on the whole. The bending moments are induced at the crown by horizontal displacement, whereas bending moment at the crown in case of 3-inch arch is zero. Fixed arch is not flexible at the 3-inch or 2-inch. Thus, the bending moments are induced due to settlements. Considering the temperature effect, any rise or fall in temperature causes stresses in the rib of the arch. The horizontal thrust is very much affected by the change in the temperature. The estimation of temperature stresses is important in the design of reinforced concrete and steel arches. In case of 3-inch arches, relative rotations between the members is possible. This affects the reduction in the stresses. In case of 2-inch arches, they are not that flexible. Considering the stiffness, in case of 3-inch arch, presence of 3 inches reduces the overall stiffness of the arch. Thus, the 3-inch arch deforms more than 2-inch arch or fixed arch. Hence, it may not be a good choice from deflection point of view. The degree of resistance of a 2-inch arch is more than 3-inch arch, but less than the fixed arch. Fixed arch is stiffer to other arches as it deflects less. So if you consider arch versus beam for the same span, arches are more efficient. Here is a simple case of simply supported beam with the 3-point loads and an arch with the same 3-point loads at the same distance. The bending moment at any section is given by the moment due to the loads, that is positive, and moment due to the horizontal thrust, that is minus h into y, which is negative. Hence, the bending moment at any section, if you consider, the moment is drastically reduced by the moment due to h into y. Case of 3-inch arch, we come across two parameters. One is normal thrust and other is radial shear. So normal thrust is perpendicular to the section and radial thrust is radial to the section. Normal thrust will be equal to Nt, that is equal to F sin theta plus H cos theta, or V sin theta plus H cos theta, and radial thrust Rs will be equal to F cos theta minus H sin theta. The geometric properties of parabolic arch are, because at any for a parabolic arch you are required to find the height of the section, so where y is equal to, that is k into x into l minus x, here k is the constant to be determined with the relevant boundary conditions. At x equal to l by 2, y is equal to yc, that is the height of the crown. Therefore, yc will be equal to k into L by 2 into L by 2, that is k is equal to 4 yc by L square. Hence y will be equal to 4yc divided by l square into x into l minus x. dy by dx equal to 4yc divided by l square into l minus 2x. Thank you.